Hey, Pete, this is Kevin. I appreciate the time. I just wanted to take this opportunity and record a little interview with you. We've had the opportunity to do some work with you, and I just wanted to give you the opportunity to introduce yourself to the folks and tell us just a little bit about you, you know, title, how long you've been in the position, all that kind of good stuff.
Yeah, my name is Pete Ketcher. I'm the manager of food and nutrition for the IU Health Systems North Central Region. I've been in the business for healthcare patient service feeding for 10 years at IU, an additional 5 years at another hospital in the same town.
Cool. How big a staff do you guys have at your location?
We currently have an executive chef, 5 team lead supervisor, and about 90 staff members between the two hospitals.
That's quite a bit. That does probably keep you running, doesn't it?
It does keep me busy.
I bet. Basically, so we'll just kind of dive into it. What was the problem that, you know, before we got engaged, what was basically the problem that you were trying to solve?
We were trying to solve the tray accuracy, tray times, the paperwork on top of paperwork, the inability to receive data in a timely manner. So part of the process is to track tray times for patients manually by hand at a number of checkpoints throughout the process. And that just wasn't being done consistently, and then we weren't receiving real-time data where we could then kind of take that data and further educate and talk to the staff about the issues that may have happened that day, the previous week, whatever the case may be. We can currently do that now with the system that's going to be set up.
Perfect. So what was, sounded like you had a bunch of different touch points. What was the kind of the real frustration behind all that?
It wasn't getting done. So was it from the start of the call, when the patient calls to the call center operator, they were overloaded with their work, so they weren't able to jot it down manually to basically staff forging their numbers at various touch points of the process, whether it be the time it left the kitchen, the time it hit the patient room, the time we picked up the tray. Those numbers weren't as accurate as they should be, where we can kind of do something with that information and create the metrics.
Perfect. Okay. So how did you hear about us? How did you find us? How did we first come to meet each other?
So the first time I heard about you was through our facilities manager, who was previously working with you and using you to what I believe is putting stuff on electronic files. And so I create a number of paper documents through transactions that happen in our cafe and a number of the other cafes, on top of the paperwork that we see through patient meals, all these trackings. So I needed to find a way to reduce the amount of paper, which would increase my storage space so I could do other things. And he kind of referred me to you.
Yeah, you were killing some trees.
Killing lots of trees.
Yeah.
So
yep.
We're trying to go paperless with as much as we can. And then that kind of led to this conversation where we thought we can put this process in place to track our tray tracking.
Yeah, we kind of thought there had to be a better way. I know you had other options. Obviously, you know, we're not the first guys to solve this problem. But what kind of what made you decide to pull the trigger and move forward with this solution?
The other option that we had was use our current CBoard system. The problem with that is that the cost of upgrading it to the ability to tray track and use the tray tracking was expensive. And the ability to install it in a timely manner, where we've been promised over the last few years, it'll be next year, and next year never came. The ease at which we were able to work together and come up with this solution, very similar to what I wanted and exactly what the staff wanted, was kind of let me to this situation with you now.
Perfect. It took us, we started back in October, I think.
I thought it was a fairly quick process. You know, some of the great points with your staff were the ease at which my staff could work with them, from the frontline staff to the supervisors, and they had just as many good recommendations as my staff had back at them.
Perfect.
It was a great team effort by both sides.
Yeah, it's been a pleasure working with you guys. I mean, Lindsay is just a breath of fresh air, and
amazing.
Everybody else on your staff has just been fun to work with as well. You know, I'm going to be transparent, is that, you know, we're just kind of getting this off the ground. We've had a lot of testing and a lot of kind of beta alpha days out there, and it's just starting to get off the ground. But in your mind, what kind of metrics do you think that this solution is going to impact?
So our goal is to take care of the patient as best we can. And the way we can do that is make sure we serve hot food hot, cold food cold in a timely manner, so the taste of the food is good and the appearance is great. The patients get surveyed on 5 questions. 3 of the questions are appearance of food, taste of food, quality of food. The other ones are missing items and then how nice our people are. So nobody really wants to have that dirty, smelly tray left in their room for over an hour. So
exactly.
This will give us that ability to make sure we pick those trays up with different triggers on the iPads, and make sure that experience from the time they order to the time it's picked up is met.
That's
cool. Our goal is out the kitchen door in 20 minutes from day to now, and it may say hit the patients in 30 minutes. So we can react in real time. Maybe it might be an individual problem, might be an uncontrolled technology problem from the printers, but we'll have that ability to now to kind of track all that and solve those issues.
So, I mean, bottom line is people kind of vote with their stomachs, right? You know, if things taste good, they're going to give you a good score. And is that that's linked back to kind of the overall hospital's performance, I'm sure, as the customers are walking out the door or the patients are walking out the door, they kind of give you a rating, correct?
That is correct. Actually, a portion of reimbursement from the government via the insurance companies is based on patient satisfaction. And so we don't want to leave any of that reimbursement on the table. We want 100% of that back to us.
I'm sure you don't want to leave a dime on the table and walk away, get as much from the government as you can, right?
Especially if we're already doing the service. Let's just make sure it's the best service possible.
Excellent. Anything, like I said, I want to keep this real quick and to the point, but anything I haven't asked, any other questions that that we should talk about?
No, you know, this is just another way. We are into transformation and doing things leaner. I think this is fitting right into that category, and not only making my staff more efficient, they feel more engaged because they were part of the solution and the ownership of this process. So the whole mission, or one of the missions of IU right now, is to do things in a lean way. And so this kind of met every single one of those touch points.
Cool. Anything that you would say to anybody that was kind of considering going down this path?
I would say I highly recommend using you guys.
Well, I appreciate that.
Yes, I mean, but
not fishing for compliments, but yeah.
No. But, you know, you have the ability to morph and modify how we wanted our system to work here. If I used a different system, I wouldn't have that ability. Mm. So that's kind of been the greatest asset that you guys kind of gave to us, and we'll use that down the road with different projects, I hope, in our area with our partnership. So that's probably the best thing for my staff.
Perfect. Perfect. Well, Pete, I appreciate the time, and look forward to continue working with you.
Me too. That's a pleasure. Thanks, Kevin. Thanks for the call.
Thank you, sir. Bye-bye.
All right.